to select entire rows and columns, I first want to hover my mouse over the edge of the working area where the gray numbers and letters are until my cursor turns into a black arrow, and then hold down my left mouse button and then drag to include additional columns in my highlighted area. And in this case, notice that what at first glance appears to be single columns are actually groups of two columns that always need to stay together. There are several systems to win templates like that, so always be sure to select the entire logical grouping of columns or rows. Selecting entire rows or columns is particularly important on templates like the Gantt chart or the standard work combination sheet, because there are more columns off from your viewing area that contain more calculations. And if you're using Microsoft Excel 2010 or higher, then you now also need to be aware of a new bug that Microsoft has told us they have no intention of fixing, and that is that when you select a large number of hidden rows or columns in a protected worksheet, it can be very slow before it allows you to do anything else. In our Known Issues online training, we teach you several ways to get around this bug, but the easiest way is usually to simply unprotect the sheet before selecting a large number of rows or columns. If all you want to do is hide or unhide rows or columns, then you can get around the Excel 2010 bug by using this method, even on a protected worksheet. Rather than selecting the entire columns spanning the hidden columns, instead, what you want to do is select the cells in just one row. Select cells spanning the hidden columns. And then on the Home tab, you select Format, Hide and Unhide, Unhide Columns. And in that way, you too can unhide columns just as quickly as you used to before you upgraded. Deleting entire rows or columns is by far the most dangerous thing that you can do. And it's usually a bad idea. We're not even going to teach you how to do it. It's usually a far better idea to hide columns or rows that you don't want to use. So how do we insert new columns or rows? A newcomer to Excel might simply right-click, Insert Rows. And on some simple spreadsheets, you can get away with that, but it's often a bad idea to simply insert rows, because your inserted rows might be missing hidden formulas or formatting that you might not even notice are missing at first glance. The right way to insert rows or columns is actually to copy blank rows or columns that already contain the formulas and formats that you want in your new ones. As you can see from our online training, the easiest way is probably to use Insert Copied Cells, which only appears as a menu option after you have selected and copied some cells. To do this, you simply select the rows or columns that you want to copy, then copy them using Ctrl+C or your favorite way of copying, then select the first cell in the row where you want to paste, then select the Home tab, Insert, Insert Copied Cells. And notice that that menu option is only there after you've copied some cells that can be inserted. And it's as easy as that. Notice that unlike regular paste, it didn't just overwrite the cells in row 17. It actually shifted down the other rows beneath it and inserted your new copied row. Now the other way of doing the same thing is shift down and copy. And I actually use this even more frequently than insert copied cells. It requires a little more mouse skills, so you're going to want to practice it. You again start by selecting the rows or columns that you want to copy. Then you hover your mouse over the edge of the blue highlighted area until your mouse turns into a four-sided cross arrows. Then you right click and drag to where you want to copy. And when you release your right mouse button, you select Shift Down and Copy. So rather than simply inserting rows, you want to copy a similar blank row instead. And then that way you know you've got all the formatting and formats and hidden stuff too. It's the right way to do it. To move columns and rows, you use Shift, Right, and Move. Do everything just like we taught you for copying rows and columns. But when you release your right mouse button, choose Shift, Right, and Move instead of Shift, Right, and Copy. That sure beats the old-fashioned way of inserting new columns where you want your new ones and then going back and copying and going back to where you copied from and deleting those old columns. So you've learned some new tricks today, and please teach these to others within your company because these are absolutely critical. Shift down and copy, shift down and move are absolutely critical to not only getting the most out of your Systems to Win templates, but getting the most out of Excel in general.